Okay, twice a number C. What does twice a number, how do I get twice a number?
2C.
Two times the number, right? Two times C is exactly what that is. Okay, so 2C needs to be at least, 2C needs to be at least, which means that this number, negative 4/9, okay, we know there's a relationship between 2C and negative 4/9. It needs to be at least negative 4/9, so that means that it can also be bigger, or it can also be smaller than negative 4/9.
Yeah, it can be smaller.
Can it be smaller than negative 4/9? Could it be, negative 10? Would negative 10 work?
No.
Would that be at least negative 4/9? No, that's even more least, right? It's less than negative 4/9. Could it be 0?
Yeah.
It could be 0. 0 is at least negative 4/9. It's more than 4/9. So this 2c here needs to be greater than or equal to negative 4/9, just as at least, at the smallest, it needs to be negative 4/9. So it could be negative 4/9, or it could be bigger than negative 4/9. Okay? That make sense?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
So
well,
the littlest number is always the
littlest number.
You know, where do they get it, what I'm saying?
Are you asking, like, which way does the symbol go?
Yeah, it's always the smallest number, right?
It points in the direction of the smaller number.
Yeah, I know,
yeah.
It's always the smallest number.
Yeah. Whatever the smaller number is supposed to be, it always points to the smaller number. Like, if it were written in the reverse order, like this was on the left, and this were on the right, and then we would want it to point in this direction because it needs to point at the smaller number.
So what happens if X? I mean, never mind. Okay. 20 and 18. Then 18, the small thing would go.
20 and 18, okay.
Yeah.
So we had 20 and 18.
Yeah, so 18 is the little thing you put on.
Go like that.
Yeah, like what I thought.
I think of it as, like I told you last time, the equal sign.
No. Oh, yeah, about the. It goes up.
Tilted
and down
each.
And yeah, side. If it's tilted this way.
So, I think of it like an equal sign that two sides have been squashed together. Okay. So the bigness and the smallness, in my mind at least, is the distance between the two sides. So the distance on this side, right, is bigger than the distance between these two. There's no distance there.
Okay.
Okay. So distance between the two lines that we use to make the symbol, the distance is small here. Small, right there, and large, right? There's the distance right there, large. And I would bet any amount of money that whoever invented that symbol or group that invented that symbol, that's what they intended, right? Smaller side, larger side.
Life savings?
I bet my life savings. There's no way to verify it, because who knows?
Wait, can we look up on the internet?
You look at, I wouldn't trust any source on the internet or anywhere else. Tell me definitively the story of the origins of the greater than less than sign. But I'd be interested to hear it, but we'll never know. So we get a time machine and we can go back to the very first instance.
I don't think we're gonna live that long.
To see time travel.
I am. Well, you know,
all
right. I'm gonna
so looks like we cleared that question up. 12.
I don't think
we'll
be able to change.
Oh, one more page.
Okay.
Is greater than negative 3, and the only question here is this a solution to this inequality? It's just that yes or no answer, right? Yes it is, or no it's not a solution. How do we find out?
We plug in 4 and we plug in negative 2.
All right, just take this guy, we plug it in, we have missed.
Yeah.
2. Try again. Plug it in right there. So 15 times negative 2, greater than negative 3, we're gonna answer this question. Is 15 times negative 2?
Negative 30.
Is negative 30 greater than negative 3?
False statement.
It's a false statement. It's saying that it is, but it isn't. So it's not a solution. All right. you're driving with a learner's license, a licensed driver who is 21 years of age or older, okay? So there's this person. Can they be 21?
Yes.
Let's look at it on an underline, maybe. Can this person be 21? You said yes, agreeing that this person could be 21, it'd be all legal for you to have them be your
assistant.
Assistant, yes. Let's say assistant. Okay, so yes, 21, good to go. Can this person be 20?
No.
No,
can't be 20. Can they be 22?
Yes.
21 or higher.
21 or higher. Can they be 21 and a half?
Yes.
Can it be anything that's 20 or higher? So when we write this with an inequality, we need the math symbols that we've learned, it needs to reflect exactly that, right? So x can be, if x represents this person's age, it can be anywhere from here to here, and here means, you know, on to infinity. So this person can be infinity years old. And it would be perfectly legal for them to drive this car. Okay? Yes?
But students that drive with someone that are 21 years old, they're usually like 15 or 16.
Okay, but this is talking about the age of the person who is in the passenger seat while the learner is driving.
So it'd be X pointing.
So X needs to be, does it need to be bigger than 21 or smaller than 21?
Bigger.
Bigger or the same.
Bigger or the same as 21.
Because you don't know what X is.
Right. It could be anything. It could be from 21 to, I don't know, 120. I don't know how.
It could be up to
the oldest person is right now. Is that?
It's a billion.
Yeah. Nobody's a billion years old.
Actually, yes, they're. No. Well, they're not alive, but they're still alive.
No.
Maybe.
They're called dinosaurs.
Careful with that.
No, actually.
You have a dinosaur in the car, and a police officer pulls you over, and you're like, oh, this dinosaur is billions of years old.
Yep.
It's going to say, well,
it has to be a
human
person.
Being.
No,
we'll
or you just
yeah,
send you to
a I can say my dog.
Or they just send you to a mental institution.
Yeah, they probably would do that.
I like cracking this too.
All right, so a human driver, only human, or human passengers only, no dinosaurs, no one single-celled amoeba, one map. All right, any questions? Feel like you got it?
Homework review.
I bet you got it. Let's homework review. You got a piece of paper, put everything else away, please. Go. Okay, so 3 times the number h plus 6 is less than 12. So let's start with 3 times the number h. We write 3 times the number h. What?
3h.
Did you say 3h?
Yeah, I think so.
3H.
4H.
Okay, 3 times the number H plus 6.
Plus
6. Oh, gosh. Plus how else to really say plus 6 than plus 6?
I think I got these right.
All right, it's got some kind of a relationship with 12.
Right here.
It's like this.
Oh, so dance signs.
Yeah.
Like that. Less than 12.
Or it could be equal to.
It doesn't
no.
say equal to, it just says less.
Shoot.
Yeah.
I forgot, I didn't write the 6.
You can spell the word.
Didn't write the 6.
Like
I did that right.
Made.
So if you see a little line under it, then I mean,
someone else did that?
Yeah.
Someone wrote that on afterwards.
I think you might have done it. I think you've been writing
probably
on my paper.
Right.
Will I do?
Put a little line into that on Tyler's overview.
That kind
yep.
of
yeah.
people are
totally
out to get
yeah, I got that right.
This is fun and all, but it is taking up time. Let's not take
sorry,
up
guys.
Time. Let's get to that today. 3 p.m. Graph the following inequality. X is greater than or equal to 4. So first we need something to graph it on. We also need to show where the number 4 is. What kind?
Not filled in.
Can X be 4?
Yes. So filled in.
Yeah,
oh, I got that mixed up then.
Can it be 3?
No.
Can it be
5?
Yes.
Okay, it can be anything this way.
I got it right.
Oh,
sorry,
I got
it
wrong.
Yeah.
I got it right.
Wait, how would it be less than? Oh, X can be anything higher than that. So
we're
gonna go up. Oh.
Did you get both of them wrong?
No. Yeah.
All right. Making sure we have our notes out. Okay.
Thanks.
I'm gonna ask you a question. Is this true?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So I didn't use numbers. I used objects.
Objects.
Right. How many objects are here?
Seven.
And on this side,
seven.
Now, I'm going to change this a little bit. I'm going to ask you if it's still true. Okay. I'm going to bring this into the mix. If I put one of these over here, is it still true?
Yes.
No.
No.
No, it is not. Not if you have one over there.
Oh, if you put one.
It's equal.
Okay. It could be less than or equal to.
No.
Here's one idea, Bruce.
Why is
it
different color, though?
Just so that you can tell the difference between what we started with and what I got.
I thought it was a totally different, like, exponent.
They're the same. Okay. An exponent. I see what you're saying there. Put it to the first power. This is 8. Or what is this?
That's 7.
Now it's 8. It's not true anymore. Now, one idea that was suggested was we put a little line right there. Okay. Well, let's say that that's true. Let's say I add 1 to this side. Now is it true?
No.
It's equal. And there's not really anything I can do to make it true. It's definitely false. I guess if I flip this around, but we're getting silly with our ideas here. The point I'm trying to make is if I don't change the symbol, then
that's false.
Yes, exactly. So it's the same thing as with equations, right? Whatever I do to one side,
you have to do
to the other side. Otherwise, even though it's not the same as this, right?
It's the balance.
This is balanced, right? Equations are balanced. This balance?
No.
It's purposefully unbalanced. Mm-hmm. But if I start adding things to one side and not the other, I could switch the relationship. One side could become bigger. Right?
It could be.
But if I put one here and one here, it'll stay
equal,
just as unbalanced as it started.
Mm-hmm.
That makes sense. So this isn't exactly right, but it's kind of like it's unbalanced. This thing is not flat. It's angled. I want to keep that exact same angle throughout the entire process, right? Does that make sense? So, I don't like that. So to not throw it off, I need to do the same thing to both sides. That's the only point I'm trying to make. Can we all agree?
Agree.
That makes sense?
Yeah.
What we do to one side, we do to the other. So that we don't inadvertently change the relationship between the two sides. Even though they're not balanced, they are the way that they need to be. They need to stay that same relationship.
I just get confused, but when you're doing the graphing stuff, you know, when you're supposed to graph it, it's weird because it goes this way. I mean, it goes up and it goes that way. But then,
let's get through this and then we can go back and we're doing that. Okay.
Okay,
so whatever we do to one side, we need to do the other. If we add something to one side, add the same to the other, if we subtract something from one side, subtract that same thing from the other side. If I take, I locked this up. Hold on. If I take one from this side, I need to also take one from this side. If I do step out of balance, if I don't do the same thing to both sides, then I throw it. Okay. So when we solve inequalities, we have the same mentality as when we solve equations, and that is we do the same thing to both sides. So if we had, say, x minus 4 is greater than 8. Can someone solve that inequality for me and tell me how they did it? Aiden?
It's kind of like when there's an equal sign. When you add
4
to the same side.
Add 4. If I add, just like we talked about, if we add some stuff on this side,
and add it to another.
We need to add it to the other side.
Ooh.
Negative 4 plus 4. It's nothing, so we have x plus nothing is greater than
8.
12.
See, that's what I thought.
Okay.
People are saying that.
Now think about that for a second. Think about how that does make sense, because if I want this quantity, some number minus 4, to be bigger than 8, well, this guy's got to be bigger than 12. Because
mm-hmm.
I'm about to subtract 4 from it.
Right.
And I want it to be bigger than 8, so it's got to be 12, at least 12.0000001.
Right.
At least a little bit bigger than 12.
So if you had to graph that right there, 12.
You have to graph it, okay?
X is right. bigger than. Oh,
so here's 12, right? The number 12. So here's 0. What do you do?
You just need
12.
So then it would be going up.
So x can be, can it be 13?
Yeah.
It can be 14.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So it can be any of these guys out here.
But it can't be. It can't be less than.
So it's 12. An open circle.
Can it be 12?
Yeah. No.
No.
Unless
it can't
you
be
put
12.
The up, unless
it could be 12.
It has the equal sign,
right?
Right.
So open
okay.
circle. No, it cannot be 20. It cannot be 12. It has to stop. Once it gets to the 12, it cannot be 12, I think that's to say. It needs to just not let x be 12 or anything less. Okay. So just establishing a fairly straightforward property of solving inequalities, whatever I do to one side, I do to the other. All right. It's not for the exact same reasons as for an equation, right? We're not trying to keep it balanced. What we're actually trying to do is keep it exactly as unbalanced as it was to start with. Let's just also confirm this with some numbers. Like 6 is greater than 1. 6 greater than 1?
Yeah.
Yeah.
As long as they do the same thing to both sides, you know, this will stay true. The left side will be bigger than the right side, right? If I subtract 7, what do we get on the left side?
-1.
Is -1 greater than?
-6.
-6?
Yep.
Yeah.
It is greater than the right. Yes?
Is there any specific reason you pick 7? Or not?
No reason at all. Just randomly chose 7.
Okay. Just showing that if we do the same thing to both sides, this will still, you know, we could point in the right direction. This side will always be bigger than this side. Okay.
So it's kind of like an equivalent fraction.
Equivalent fraction?
Yeah. Like if you were to take one over the other. I don't know.
Yes, kind of, in a way. Because in fractions, those numbers are rarely the same number. One's bigger than the other.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So you're going to do the same thing to both. It's kind of like that, yeah. Let's try one more, like x plus 9 is greater than 15. We're going to solve this. Somebody different. Somebody other than Aiden.
I will.
Kyler, what are we going to do?
Minus 9.
6. Greater than 6.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That makes sense. If for this number plus 9 to be bigger than 15, then this number needs to be bigger than 6. If it's 6 or anything less than 6, it's not going to be big enough. So by subtracting 9 from both sides, we find exactly what x can be. X can be exactly anything that's bigger than 6. 6 is the exact cutoff for what x can be. All right. Well, that's what we see in 3.2. We're just adding and subtracting from both sides. Let's think about a real world a problem we can talk about in the book.
Y equals AC plus B.
I don't know what you're talking about. So when you get on a train or a plane, they allow you to take baggage with you. They don't like throw in the baggage area. You can keep it with you at your seat. That's called carry-on luggage. Train, it has to be at most, I believe it says at most, no, it says no more than 50 pounds. Okay, 50 pounds. It has to be no more than 50 pounds. Okay, so let's say this is how much your bag weighs. So your bag needs to be what in relation to 50?
50
no
or
more
less
than
50 or less than
50 or the same as 50?
No.
Less than or equal to.
Less than or equal to 50. It needs to be no more than 50. Less than 50 or the same as 50. Okay, well let's open our bag here. So we're at home, we're packing up our bag. Our bag already weighs 24.8 pounds. Weighs 24.8 pounds. We're gonna put more into it. Okay? Maybe we still need to pack our favorite shirts or something. So it already raised 24.8 pounds already. We're going to put some more in there. What inequality could be right to incorporate 24.8 and the amount that we're still going to put in there?
24.8 plus x.
Good.
Is less than or equal to 50.
Exactly. 24.8, the existing weight, plus the amount of weight we still are going to add on, needs to be less than or equal to 50. Okay. Now we need to figure out how big is x.
Minus 24.8 on each side.
That's 24.8 on both sides. So x, the amount that you're going to add on, needs to be less than or equal to something. Less than or equal to 25.2.
Confirm if you wanted to grab a calculator. Pretty sure that's right. Yes?
What would you do if there was about e cosine 2 and how do you do less? Like, if you less than or equal to what would you do?
Well, solving for x wouldn't be much different. I mean, if there weren't that equal to part, then the whole problem would just look like that. Does that answer the question? Or are you asking something different, like how would the problem read if that were the case?
Well, I don't know.
Can we graph that?
Yeah.
Could you graph that?
Sorry.
But it was equal to, so let's keep it true to what the problem was. So 25.2, here's 0, here's 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 25.2 is like right there. Can the amount that you added to your bag be exactly 25.2 pounds?
Yes.
Can be exactly that much. You put a closed circle there, and it can be 30 pounds.
No.
No, that's too big. It's
25.2 or less.
So we could add all the way down to 0 pounds. We could add negative pounds. How would we add negative pounds?
Taking stuff away. Make minus.
We could take stuff out. We could pack helium balloons.
Okay. So what I was saying is that would be out. Wouldn't this be untrue though if that the equal to line wasn't there? Because that would be equal then.
So if it weren't there, okay, so it would be like the rules of the train company would be that your bag has to be less than 50. If it hits 50, it's too much.
Yeah.
Right? So it cannot be 50, it has to be less than 50. So that means that the amount that you add has to be strictly less than 25.2, which really for the graph, all that means is that this dot should be open.
Oh, okay.
Nothing else really changed.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I was about to ask the same question you just did. Never mind.
Okay.
I was confused.
So if there weren't an equal to, the only thing that would change is we would just leave an open circle there. But it does have an equal to, so then leave that all there. Alright. A few quick examples to show you how inequalities are a little bit funny when we multiply and divide both sides. Okay, so we've added and we subtracted from both sides, now we're going to multiply and divide both sides. Let's just start with an example of an equation 12 equals 12. And I'm just using numbers, strictly numbers, so you can see how this works. I'm not throwing in variables at the end. So 12 equals 12. No matter what I do, as long as I do it to both sides, this should still be true, right?
Right.
So divide by 2.
Oh, I already divided by 2.
So divide by 2. What do we get?
6
equals 6. Is that true?
Yes.
Okay, let's divide by 6 now. Let's divide both sides by 6. What do we get?
2 equals 2.
Is that true?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, great.
Thank you.
Quiet.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now let's divide by negative 2. What do we get?
Negative 6.
Is that true?
Yep.
All right. I also got another, a new example, an example with inequality. So let's say 2 is less than, let's say negative 2 is less than 6. So let's again divide both sides.
By negative 2.
Let's divide by 2 first. Divide by 2. Right? What do we get on the left side?
Negative 1.
What do we get on the right side?
3.
Is that still true?
Yes.
Still true. Try
negative 2.
You're jumping ahead just a little bit too much. So let's multiply both sides by 4. Multiply both sides by 4. See if it's still true. 4 times negative 2 is?
Negative 8.
6 times 4?
24.
Still true.
Yeah.
Okay, now let's see what happens. When we divide by negative 2. Divide by negative 2? Divide by negative 2. Negative 2 divided by negative 2 is?
1.
Divide. The negative, or 6 divided by negative 2 is?
Negative 3.
Is this true?
We don't know.
1 is not less than negative 3. That's kind of weird. But can you see kind of why that happened when we divided by a negative?
Yeah.
What happens when you divide this negative by a negative? What do you get?
A positive.
A positive. So let's like think about these numbers on a number line. We had a negative 2. It's over here on the left side. And we divide by a negative 2, we wind up with this positive number. It's over there on the right side. We divide this positive 6 by a negative 2. What was a positive number is now a negative number. Right? So they like traded spots. Like the one on the left went on the right, the one on the right went on the left. By left and right, I mean negative and positive. Okay. So what was now smaller is actually bigger. What was bigger is now smaller. Right? You see, they kind of flip flopped. They traded places in a way. The thing that was actually smaller now becomes a larger number because it is now positive. The thing that was bigger because it was positive is smaller because it's now negative. How do we fix that? Like they switch positions. How can we make this true? Did we divide by negative 2 correctly? We divided by negative 2, we got positive 1, 6 divided by negative 2, negative 3, yeah.
Since you're dividing by the opposite, would you do the opposite for the sign?
Because it kind of, well, I guess we could handle this two different ways. I could put the negative 3 over here, right? Because it's now on the left hand side, it's over on the left, and the negatives. I could put this guy over here as positive 1, negative 3 is less than 1. Is that true? Yeah, because they kind of have, with a positive has now become negative, negatives have now become positive, we kind of switch places. Or, if I were to just bring everything straight down to make this statement true, I can bring down the 1 and the negative 3, and now they've switched, so I should switch the sign as well, switch that inequality sign. Either way you want to do it. Most common thing is to take that sign and flip it around. Let's take negative 2 is less than 6 and multiply both sides by negative 2. What's negative 2 times negative 2?
4.
4. So this was a negative 2, now it's positive 4. Now it's in the positives, it's a big number. 6 times negative 2 is?
Negative 3.
Negative 12. Now it's jumped back in. That thing, that the number on the right side has become a negative number, right? So the relationship has switched. Smaller side has now become the larger side. The larger side has become the smaller side. Flip them around. So if you multiply, multiply, or divide by a negative on both sides, flip the sign around or switch the sides, like to put the right thing on the left and the left thing on the right, but I think most often we're going to switch that sign around if you give the choice. Flip the inequality sign. So, solve this inequality. 3x is greater than 21. We're going to solve this inequality.
Divide by
3. So x needs to be bigger than 7. Let's just think about it for a second, see if that makes sense. If 3 times a number needs to be bigger than 21, should that number be bigger than 7?
Yeah, that makes perfect sense.
3 number should be bigger than 7.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. So just no flipping. Just
dropping it down.
Than 7. For negative 3x is greater than 21. I'm going to divide by negative 3 on both sides. If I forget what I've just been told a minute ago, I might say x is greater than negative 7. Because this doesn't make sense. If it was greater than negative 7, let's say 1. Is 1 greater than negative 7? If I put a 1 there, though, negative 3 times 1 is negative 3, and that's not bigger than 21. And in fact, the bigger this goes into the positive numbers, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the more negative this guy is going to be, right? So what we've done, we've forgotten to flip this around. So that x actually needs to be less than negative 7. So this is negative 7. Negative 3 times negative 7 is 21. It's not quite what we want, but it's bigger than that. So we let x be like negative 8. 9 or negative 10. The more into the negatives x goes, past negative 7, the bigger this side is going to be. If you want it to be big, much bigger than 21. Negative x over 4 is less than or equal to 2. How are we going to solve this inequality? X needs to be multiplied by a negative, so it needs to be greater than or equal to negative. Or whether you multiply or divide by a negative on both sides, you flip that inequality sign around. Because two sides are kind of.
So if you multiply, you have to flip it around.
Say again.
If you multiply, you have to flip it around.
By a negative.
By a negative.
Yes.
All right.
Multiply by a negative. Flip the sign around. Divide by a negative, flip the sign around. Other than that little flipping around thing that happens, solving inequalities is exactly like solving equations. It only catches that flipping around rule when you divide and multiply by a negative on both sides. Any questions?
So as long as you are multiplying by a positive number or dividing the number, you have to worry about that.
It is only when you multiply or divide by a negative number. Is that negative?
And not both sides are negative. Like, would you have to do that if it is negative 2?
Whatever the numbers that you start with, if you multiply or divide by a negative number on both sides, you flip it around.
So, like, if it was.
Doesn't matter if this is a negative 2 to start with.
Okay.
And multiplying or dividing by a negative always switches the sign. So it always makes the two sides, like the smaller side now becomes larger, and the larger side now becomes smaller. We can confirm that with like 2 is less than 4, or negative 3 is greater than negative 8. Okay? Are these two statements true? 2 less than 4? Is negative 3 greater than negative 8?
No.
Let's divide by a negative on both sides. Negative 2. 2 divided by negative 2 is negative 1. So this is negative 2.
Yeah, you're going to have to flip it.
Right? Is that true?
No, you'd have to flip it.
That was flipped.
Oh, no, never mind.
They kind of trade. Like, before, 4 was bigger than 2, but when you divide by a negative, it switches the sign. So big numbers that are negative are actually smaller because they're further to the left. Divide this side by a negative 1. Divide by negative 1. Negative 3 divided by negative 1 is 3. Is that greater than 8?
No.
No. Flip, so we divide that side. Multiply or divide by a negative. It doesn't matter what you started with. If you multiply or divide both sides by a negative, flip the side.